Welcome back for game two of week three of the Batty Overwatch League.
Or
Welcome
wait,
back for
was it week four?
game
No,
two
it's week
of
three.
week
No, it's
three
week
of
four.
the Batty Overwatch
Week
League.
four.
After eating all that turkey from Thanksgiving, my brain is a little hazy.
Nice.
I need another nap. I think that's what it is. But anyway, I'm UTech, and with me is the ever sexy, ever lovely 30. How are you today? How's it going, man?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Can't complain too much, just a little tired, said before, but looks like we're
Going
gonna be
to
going into
Numbani.
Numbani as the first map of the day. Now I know you're the tactical genius of the entire league. What should we be seeing in here?
Who's playing today? April Wizards, Mercy Shore?
Yep, April Wizards, Mercy Shore.
April Wizards on the blue side? No, red side. Mercy Shore on the blue side. Tactical genius, Numbani. Well, Numbani is actually, in my opinion, a pretty cool map. I hate this map, but I think it offers a lot of strategical diversity.
It's the
At this.
buses, isn't it? It's the buses.
It is. Dude, yeah, it is. Away. On this first point here for offense, they have quite a few choices on where they want to go, and it's usually just based on what kind of team composition you're running, or I guess finding out what the other team is running. Looks like we got Chromatic on the Genji here. So you can basically, there's four options. You can go streets, you can go under, you can go above, or you can go that deep left flank. Or you can just do it all at once. You can do every single one of those options at one time. But I assume with the sort of this dive composition they're running with the Winston and Genji, I think they're gonna try to go upper here and try to punch through and try to get to the back lines for the supports. Looks like they're running a Mercy and a Ana for Mercy Shore here. Mercy is super critical on this first point here for revive.
Definitely, definitely.
Be watching out for AGS Zero and how he's gonna try to stay alive against both Tacos Go Boom and Chromatic.
Looks like April Wizards starting off that push. Looks like they're taking up the left side.
Ooh.
Gonna see if they can do anything. Marias getting a few picks. Harambe jumping in, Tacos Go Boom trying to do something. A dash from Shooter Die trying to get in, and there's already a big scuffle going on in.
Chromatic's on Mercy there. He's trying to single him out. Aegis here though, he's getting this Zarya bubble. Staying alive as long as he can.
Looks like Mercy is gonna be able to be wiggly enough, try to get out. But it looks like Blaboor, not even knowing who's behind him, trying to get off other picks. But it looks like the Winston, the Mercy finally goes down. Winston doing that chip dancing with the Tesla cannon. But it looks like Mercy Shore still throwing up good defense with who they have. Still have, oh, and there comes in the ultimate from the Winston, being able to push everyone away and kind of chip everyone down.
Yeah, this might be a first point surrender really early on for Mercy Shore, and it looks like it will. They actually had a pretty good hold there for a while. The April Wizards, they didn't get any kind of capture off. It was still stuck at 0%, but basically just a beefy front line for April Wizards. That 3-10 composition kept him alive long enough in the game.
And definitely with that Chromatic on the Genji, being able to just pick off the supports of Mercy Shore, not letting them, do anything.
They're only running one support. They've only been running the Lucio, actually, here on offense. That's very interesting. It seems to be working though.
Oh, he's coming in with a nice sound barrier. And another Earth Shatter, trying to get in with nice hooks mix of damage. Marias with the visor, trying to get some damage in there. Not able to do too much, but gets picked off by Winston. But he's gonna get frozen, he's gonna be trying to come in. And Failed Destiny getting picked off by Blur. But it looks like April Wizards are gonna be able to push forward with that next skirmish.
Yep. They win the battle. Pretty close one there too. The Blizzard comes in a little too late though for Failed Destiny, only locking up Tacos Go Boom there. I'm not sure if he even went down at the very end there, but it's just sort of a full offensive blow coming in from April Wizards here. They see the enemy and they just go in on it right away. Tactical Visor started up in the back, actually. Think twice about that balcony. He's able to pick up Arias on the Soldier as well in the duel. And the Divers are just going in. The 3 DPS are just playing towards the team while you have 3 on the card still in here. Here comes the Nano Wizard Zarya out of Cruise Master. Not able to pick up a lot. Nano Wizard still getting the kill, still winning the fight. Earthshatter comes through, knocks down a couple people, but goes down in the process. Bill Destiny gonna die way too late there. Aper Wizard, they are on a frenzy right now. There's so much time left.
Mercy Shore cannot do anything against this team. They're not able to get any picks, any damage off. It is not looking good for them for this last little bit of defense. See if they can hold on to what bit they have left.
Yeah. Ult economy for both teams is pretty low here, but Chromatic, he does have that Dragon Blade. He gets the first pick of the fight, though, onto Dano. That's super critical. One healer down for Mercy Shore now, and think twice, he's still in the back. He's unanswered, basically, but gets frozen up by Mill Destiny and will get picked off. So, actually, it looks like a good hold here, finally, coming in for Mercy Shore. But Bluer's in the back! Sneaky Roadhog is in the back, someone to interrupt. Shooter died with a huge 3-man Earth Shatter. And this might just be total cleanup here.
But it looks like they're still holding on.
Oh, yeah.
They're still holding on.
All of the DPS right there was just down. No one to actually follow up on that Earth Shatter. So that's a sad day right there. Essentially wasted Earth Shatter for the time being.
Definitely think what kept them in that fight was Marias using his ult to pick off the Lucio. That was the first thing I did. So even though they had all those tanks and they were still able to hold on for quite a bit, they didn't have that speed and they did not have that healing.
Bell Destiny, he's playing with his life right now. That was so close with that hook connecting. If he goes down there, that is pretty much the map because he does have that Blizzard up. Tacos go boom, he's going in by himself, but no, actually his teammates come in for support. Blizzard goes down to try to lock up the enemy team on the offense here, but think twice instead, they get locked. Frozen up in the back, Chromatic still alive in the Genji. Nano boosted Mariah Soldier, trying to lay down as much damage as he can, and he will. 3 kills for him. Chromatic, he'll just have to go down here and die. Oh, never mind, actually gets a kill. He's still alive. Ah.
It was a good push attempt, but AGS-Zero on the Lucio was able to stay on the cart, so even though their dive cop kept moving forward, they didn't actually go for the main objective, which was the payload.
Yeah. Yeah, they're all trying to just move past it, try to get past that choke, and then fight in that big cul-de-sac area in the back. Good thought there, but Blizzard countered a lot of that action from happening. But the ult economy for April Wizards, it's a lot better now. Chromatic's gonna get Dragonblade soon here. Shooter dies not too far away from Earth Shatter. We're still missing that big support ult, the sound barrier. Which they might need here for the push.
Looks like Tacos Gaboom is gonna ult, try to poke everyone off that he can.
Yeah. Oh, and he gets slapped in the back!
Oh, but a nice black hole to make sure everyone stays there. No one's gonna come in there. Got Winston trying to get, but oh, the Earth Shatter blocked. Not able to get anyone down. And the tanks are pushing through. The defense is being whittled down.
Two down, 3 down for Mercy Shore. Now Marias, he's kind of the last hope here. He's trying to stay alive, but Chromatic's in on him. Trying to stay alive, AGS here, he's on Lucio. Hippie Hoppity trying to just stall out that card, but I don't think it's going to be enough here. Neighbor Wizards with a very dominant offense here on Nubani.
Now, looking at the play of the game, we have Marias.
I think this was right here, the cul-de-sac fight here.
Getting Nano boosted, able to pick off all those people, and get the visor off.
Yeah. Wowzers, 40% is ridiculous!
Oh man, I mean...
I've never seen 40% damage. That's ridiculous.
Marias's back must be breaking right now because he cannot carry all that.
Yeah, there could be a lot of problems with Mercy Shore. Not only on just the defense specifically around Nubani, but maybe as a team because they haven't had the hottest season so far. They've had some glimmers of real success, but a lot of the time they kind of just fold. Or I guess they break and not bend under offensive pressure. So I don't know if it's a matter of just like communicating in teamwork, keeping those supports alive, or maybe it's just not picking the right compositions for their play style, but yeah,
I think
it's,
a little
it's
bit
not
of it
good
is,
when your single DPS is 40% of your damage.
Yeah, I also think it's a little bit of, you know, just instinctual play, because if you think about it, they are trying to spread them out with that dive comp. They're trying to make it so it's like, oh, well, we have, you know, some people behind us. Who is going to really turn around and try to deal with that? And half, if you think about it, half the team is turning around while the other half is still looking forward.
Yeah.
It might be like a lack of communication just to try to, you know, tell them, like, all right, who do we really go for? Do we still look forward or do we turn back? But either way, they have to do it as a team.
Yep. Yeah, exactly. It's just... it's such a team-dependent game. And a lot of the times, it's better basically just to do everything as a single unit here. There's a lot of theory crafting that goes on in Overwatch with certain team compositions, especially dive comps. One dive comp theorized is like a 3-3 split, where you just have three divers and three, I guess, essentially backline. You just leave the backline kind of survive on their own while the divers create a bunch of space. And that works, and it definitely works at the pro level here, but I think if your team's struggling in the first place, you just gotta take that sort of solid, you know, maybe 2-2-2 lineup that just works. And not a lot of communications needed when you play that kind of stuff.
Now looking up here with the Mercy Short coming up, doing a standard composition, just try to kind of ease their way in. But it looks like April Wizards are going with the turret with Toblerone.
Ooh, Cruise Master picking up that kill onto Zed. That's huge. Chromatic, he's gonna get a pick on the Widow. Back onto Cruise, but Bluer picks up a kill onto Rakente. So two tanks down for Mercy Shore right now, and shooter dice. So
yeah,
1v1
in. Mercy down, but are they able to keep up the pressure?
I don't think Chromatic has even been pressured to move from this spot right now.
I think Failed Destiny tried to get up on him, but I don't think Failed Destiny knows that you can bring up the shield matrix while you're flying. Because I did not see a single shield matrix while he was zooming right towards him.
Well, I hopefully he does.
I'm gonna keep an eye out for him to see if he does it.
Oh wait, that was weird. Yeah, Salvo was right. It was like a Bluer inside a Bluer there. At least on my screen as well. Weird, but yeah, so Toxic Kaboom, he's on this Mercy, he almost has the res, and this is where it's gonna get a little difficult for Mercy Shore here on the push. Surely I don't know, he might not have it up, it's getting real close. Oh yeah, he's gonna have it up. He's gonna totally have it here. Bryce, he's behind the Rhino Shield, Nano boosted, Deadeye, but let's out before the Nano boost can really get the damage off, and D.Va ult comes in for some zoning. Rakente and Mariah, so they're doing some work. I think twice his Toblerone turret goes down here. Cruise Master with the Earth Shatter down onto Shooter Die. 1v1 Reinhardt battle, he's gonna win that one. Chromatic's still in the back though, still getting off the free shot on this Widowmaker. Tacos Go Boom, he did use the res there, keeps his team alive. And Mercy Shore, they're trying to do their best. They're standing on the point, they're trying to contest him. Mariah's still in the back, still alive. Labour is do people know he's back there in Baby D.Va?
I don't know.
Oh, he goes down! Babur and the Baby D.Va takes out Marias. And that'll be it for that push.
I was just looking at Chromatic the entire time. He just had free range that entire time. It's like he was in the training room. Like, no one paid attention to him at all.
Yeah, and that's a serious problem. Especially, also Tacos Go Boom. I don't think he's feeling any pressure right now from anyone on Mercy Shore. They have an alright team comp. It's really the D.Va's job to just go in onto them and disrupt them and make sure that they can't stand there and get all that free DPS off. Rakente needs to maybe start landing some focus on some priority targets. Misses the one under Chromatic, but he knows, he's trying to zone him out there. Cruise Master picks up the Shooter Dime. Rise once again with the Dadai, but not. Oh, actually, he does pick up Zedekus.
Oh, but they're able to get out the supports from under them. It
looks
like they have a solid push coming in.
This is it. This is Mercy Shore's point. Oh, wait, maybe not, actually. Chromatic is still alive, he rotated all the way around onto upper there, but he's not setting the point so he can't contest it in here. He just needs to go down. He just needs to reset.
He gets pushed out by Failed Destiny. The Failed Destiny inside the Failed Destiny.
Yeah, wait, are you seeing that too?
I too am seeing that. I didn't understand what you were saying before. That's just because I wasn't looking at failed Destiny.
Ah, yeah, it looks like there's a weird D.Va bug with the spectator. Better than week one, kid. Oh, shit. That's crazy.
No, but that's something to be proud of. You definitely got that point, and that's more points than you could have ever hoped for.
Ooh, Tacticizer, yep.
Yeah, Tacticizer coming in from behind. Think twice, trying to get as much damage as can, but gets blocked primarily. Oh, but a nice Earth Shatter, getting so many people. Think twice, able to deal a lot of damage and trying to poke them off. Trying to get as many people as he can. Rikente, can you get that hook? Can you? Oh,
yeah!
Bingo!
Oh, when the Chromatic comes down the bus, ends his pro career dreams right there. Yeah. Wait, that was almost a crazy wipe from April Wizards there, but they unfortunately the Shatter and the Attack Visor were in combo together right at the exact time. But still a pretty good hold here. Alt economy looking a little bit better for Mercy Shore right now. Marais almost has that Deadeye. And he's staying in the back, he's gonna wait for this and pop it. Sound Barrier's pop for the offense here. Think twice. Maybe left on check here. Dano on the Ana, he's trying to go for it, trying to sneak him.
Chromatic gets picked off. Still, we have the Clown Fiesta going in, and a giant self-destruct that, oh, gets blocked.
Yeah.
But Swift actually got hit by that. It looks like Mirai's coming in, gets the Mercy, so is able to get their support line down.
Yeah.
But it looks like Mercy Shore still able to push, still able to have that man advantage, and they're going to get to the next point. So they have a chance to tie this up.
Oh yeah, absolutely. 4 minutes, 20 seconds. Seems like a lot of time, but this part of the map might be the hardest on Nubani. If they get out of this bridge, they'll be doing a little bit better, but they still have this choke up here around this corner that they have to try to fight through.
And if you look at it, Chromatic and Think Twice are gonna, gonna try to come in from behind. But he gets
Think
left.
Twice. Yeah, but he gets
Chromatic comes
woken
in.
Up right away.
And that's a whole team wipe, if I ever saw one.
Mm-hmm.
Combined efforts, that's a team wipe. The combined efforts of both Chromatic and, was that Shooter Die? Who was that? Was that Shooter Die? No, that was Think Twice. I can't read. I'm sorry, stream. It's my bad.
So they only had to use one ult there. They had to use Death Blossom, but they still have two really big ults. They have Earth Shatter and Rez. It would be nice if they were able to combo that. Yeah, the self-destruct with the Earth Shatter here. Cruisemaster, he's going to pick up the kill though on Shooter Die, so that Earth Shatter is not going to be used in this fight in the very least. And ooh, Babur with a nice double kill there off the self-destruct. Think twice, not picking up the kill for himself on this cowboy guy, McCree.
McCree. It's okay, we don't see him anymore after they buff Soldier. We're all soldiers now. There's no more
I almost like only play McCree. I just brain farted. So.
I think Matthew Mercer would be a little mad at you right now.
That's true. Alright, so we got... Oh, see, the cart, though, it's receding back into this ridge area, and this is really rough to try to fight uphill here. Sound Bear comes out preemptively. Shooter Die with the Earth Shatter. That's pretty big. Gonna get the charge in on the opposite Reinhardt, and swinging in the back line. Shooter Die just going crazy. Death Blossom picks up two kills before from Pickle Kill as well, and another full hold here from April Wizards. Blue, he's going deep.
Making sure they cannot get any more, but April Wizard still has 2 minutes left to get their push on, so
don't
count them out just yet.
No. They're gonna have self-destruct, and if they wait a little bit longer, they're gonna have tactical visor with a nano boost. So nano visor is very real, very scary right now. Mech comes through, it's gonna break the shield. That might actually be really good right now. Cruisemaster sniping Shooter Die in the charge, but he gets charged back into the wall. Complete mayhem, and oh man, Shooter Die Babu, they're left unchecked. And they pick up a bunch of April Wizards team members there, and yeah, it looks gonna be another broken fight here for Mercy Shore.
every time they're able to get that high ground just on top of them and not allow them to push. I definitely think Mercy Shore, like, they need to get that high ground. They need to drop someone off and get an ult off. Every time they're able to, April Wizards are able to just get the high ground and then drop Chromatic with the Reaper, and also get the Soldier, or I guess now it's McCree, but.
Okay, that could have been a lot worse. And the answer on the Earthshatter, Mohawk comes through, pushes them really to safety though. Maybe not the best. Cruisemaster, he's swinging, he's going in. He's by himself though, and he goes down. Sound Barrier now comes up, and we're picking up double kill. Death Blossom comes through, and this will definitely be it here. April Wizards really just styling on him now.
And it was a valiant attempt, but I definitely think Rikente on the Roadhog kind of pushed away some of those Earthshattered, knock-prone people.
Yeah, oh, wait a minute. Zed just went down here. They're split now. This might be it. Mill Destiny. They got eaten up by Defense Matrix. And they're going to push April Wizards really far back, but think twice. He's in the back. It's Slept? Oh, no. Is this it though for Mercy Shore? They're putting up a pretty good push here. Babur.
Oh, can they block it? No.
These are some stylish self-destructs here from Babur. Heroes never die. Rez comes through now, and oh man, yeah. Overtime situation here for Mercy Shore, and these are so incredibly tough on these payloads. If it's especially far away from the spawn. Which it kinda is at this point. Bryce switching over to that Tracer just to try to get to the payload and extend that overtime. Death Blossom comes through just to try to zone him away. 3 kills for Chromatic, and that's going to be a Mercy Shore win there on Nubani.
Well, if you think about it, if you can't shoot them, ult them away.
Oh, wait, April Wizards. Wait a minute.
But no, but it's Chromatic and Reaper coming in. No one sees him, and he ults. And he shoots, he scores, and no one expected it. That's a fastball special right there, if I've ever seen one.
Wait a minute, isn't it April Wizards? Isn't Chromatic's name April Wizards?
Yeah.
Okay, they had the names wrong. I'm pretty sure.
No, I didn't think that.
Because it definitely just said Mercy Shore Chromatic on my screen. So.
Well, then maybe Mercy Shore actually won. Who knows?
No, it was definitely April Wizards. Yeah, we forgot to switch the name there. On that second half, but no worries. I think I was saying it right the whole time. I'd say better ult usage. The ult economy always seemed a little bit stronger on April Wizard side. They didn't overcommit on anything. They used just one or two ults per fight. They always had that res, it seemed like, in their back pocket for the real big fights where Mercy Shore was bringing all the heat with their ultimates, so all of that's practically negated.
I also have to give, you know, a lot of credit to the two DPS with Think Twice and Chromatic, especially in that last bit of defense. They were able to kind of, or Think Twice was able to kind of like come in from behind and then just distract them, and then especially with that play of the game, that was when Chromatic was able to kind of hit them when they weren't looking, and then just get a beautiful Death Blossom in the face of everyone in Mercy Shore.
Yeah, absolutely. What's your ping at right now?
My ping?
Yeah.
Can I like type slash ping?
No, in options. Oh wait, we can't open up the options in this.
No, we can't. We have to leave. Thanks, Blizzard.
Yeah.
But I think.
Oh, no, no, no. Hit Control Shift R.
Control Shift and R. I have 166 MS. What the fuck?
Yeah. No, Chromatic just whispered me that he's getting some pretty intense lag there as well. Looks like he just restarted his client. I'm wondering if anyone else actually is experiencing the game. Tree has 176 as well, huh?
Should we restart it so that...
I don't know. Is this an Overwatch thing? Or, I mean, now that if Tree has it too, then that wouldn't add up to a theory of, like, Eyes. Yeah, no. Well, actually, yeah, Chromatic's really far away too. It might be an Overwatch thing right now. Add up to a theory of like.
Mine's a solid 166.
Yeah, well, mine is two, and I wonder if it's just not updated on the menu. Because it's just staying there. None of these other things are changing either, like FPS and stuff.
Anyway, yeah. If they're good, if they feel like they're okay, they're not feeling it, I think we should be fine. On to the next one.
Oh, man, yeah. Everyone's got high ping.
Yeah.
Huh.
They really want to play with that?
I mean, it's a fair fight if everyone's at 160 plus ping.
All right. I'm gonna be prepared to see a Roadhog hook that's like, you know, 10 feet away.
That's why none of these have been landing. Rakenti, you're still good. You're still good, man.
Yeah, no, man. We can blame it. This time we can legit blame it on the lag. All right, now we just gotta change it to Li Zhang Tower, and we are good to go.
Yep. Li Zhang Tower. Oh.
Oh man, if only we had someone in the background to change. Oh, there we go, Li Zhang Tower. All right, that's good.
Yep.
As always, we should be grateful to our production overlords who can mute us at any moment.
Yes. Yeah, they could just end this shindig at any moment.
And it looks like we're going into Li Zhang Tower all the way over in China. I mean, I don't know about you, but it feels great that we're able to transport anywhere in the world. It's just, you know, the flick of a button.
Yeah. It's amazing what the world of Overwatch can give us.
Hey man, we're in the future now. Like, look at this. We got space pods. We got these solar panels on the top. Is there like a couch anywhere? Like, maybe we can. There's like, they have little desks. Maybe we can like set up our cameras there, and then just commentate from there, and it'll be like, you know,
football.
It'll be like real sports.
We could do interviews with the heroes on the game, like after the game, post game on the field interviews.
Uh-huh.
Which hero do you think would give the best interview?
I'd think either there'd be McCree. I think he'd be great because we could ask him what time it is, and every time he'd sigh. Or Tracer. I think Tracer would be a great interviewer. Or interviewee.
Oh, yeah. But what about Tracer after a loss? I don't know if she'd be so. Should be in cheering.
Not after a loss.
Yeah. Well, the action has begun here. Both teams fighting for control on that upper staircase there. Now they've moved the fight over onto the point now, and no one has died so far. Some pretty beefy lineups here, but Shooter Dot, he's gonna get walled off and discorded. He's gonna be the first one to go down here for April Wizards. And Taco's go boom on the Mercy now. He goes down as well. And wow, Mercy Shore, they're killing it right now on first point Li Zhang Tower. Look at this. Mercy Shore showing up big here. They're gonna be the first to capture the point here.
It's and they definitely have... that Maywall to pick off. The Reinhardt. I mean, definitely he was not able to do anything. He had to try to fight it out. But nothing could help him at that point.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Graviton Church pulls in everyone from Mercy Shore, but the wall is gonna come in and try and walls up pretty much everyone from April Wizards there. Shooter Dive was the only one on the other side, and AGS Hero pops his Inyata Transcendence. A little preemptively there, not gonna be able to dodge a whole lot of damage from Ryze, but he's still in the back, still doing the damage. Takes out both supports by himself. And Mercy Shore looking for another clean up here. Blue is gonna get popped out, Baby Diva. Gonna run for a little life, she's gonna get taken out. And 43% now from Mercy Shore.
And it looks like they got this. They got a good hold on this. Reaching up into 50%. They're able to kind of push up their lead and make sure that they're not able to push onto the point itself.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, so Chrismaster, he has the Graviton Surge. Now, I would really love if Mercer Sword pushed up there and met him at their entryway door and just instantly Graviton Surge. And they just got the Blizzard actually to pair it up with that as well. Think twice, trying to make a little room. He has to rain form out. Now the Graviton Surge comes out. Shujai, he's going to charge out of it. But Zed's going to get frozen up there by the Blizzard. But the res comes in from Taco Scope. Boom, sound barrier as well. It looks like April Wizards are actually going to probably win this fight.
For Kente going to try to bat everyone he can out, but not able to do too much. Not able to get any kills.
Yeah, he needs to get out of there. He needs to reset. Oh, luckily, yeah, he's able to get the jump up. Gets out safely. So now it's a retake situation here for Mercer Sword. April Wizards, though, they have three ultimates. Three really big ones that pair really, really well together. Holy crap. This is going to be brutal.
And look at it. Mercy is being super sneaky.
Wait,
what's going on?
Great. Mercy Sword coming in from behind. I don't think they saw this one coming. Graviton Surge comes in and Death Blossom comes in over the top. Think twice, jumping in, picking up two kills. Kente try to do his damnedest to answer. Taco Scoop Boom goes down as well, but it's going to be another clean sweep here for April Wizards. So, a lot was used though. Death Blossom, Graviton Surge, but we were even using the attack visor there at the very end. They're just looking at an Earth Shadow right now for April Wizards. Not a lot also on Mercy Shore. I'm curious on what the plan is here. They're just going to be a little more direct and go straight at it.
They're sneaky, but they're not cunning. Looking to get a pickup on Marias, they won't have a man advantage on the side of Mercy Shore, but so it looks like there's going to be another 20%, 15% going to be going over to April Wizards.
Yeah. Ooh, that might be really rough here. Earth Shatter goes in, he charges in, but he's going to get walled off. Shoot or die. Let's see if he can stay alive here. Transcendence comes in at the perfect time and saves his entire team here. And now the rebuttal. Mercy Shore, they sent the punch through this defense here. Cruisemaster is going to pick up the kill. Wall saves them again from the opposing Graviton Surge. Chromatic frozen up on that Zyra. Will he go down? No, he's being healed through the screen? I don't even know if that's possible, but Sound Bear now comes through for Mercy Shore. Attack Visor for Bluer. Damage boosted with the Mercy. Let's see what he can pick up. Will it be enough? Will they retain this? And now we're into overtime here for Mercy Shore. I think this fight is going to determine the game. Whoever wins this fight wins the point.
Unless Mercy Shore can keep it laid out. Like, that's gonna... If they can play the stall game, then that means that they're gonna have the man advantage coming back. Well, at least they're gonna equalize the man advantage.
Oh, yeah, Marais, he came in there at the end. He's gonna pick up Chromatic. Earthshatter goes out and just straight up murders Aegis Zero. So late. And now, oh my god, double kill. Kill Destiny here, though, as well. Marais, they're gonna do it. Mercy Shore gonna pick up that first point on Li Zhang.
I was not expecting that. Definitely thought that April Wizards was gonna get it. That was just great stall tactics on their end. Like, if you think about it, they were able to just keep it on their side, and even though they only had three people up, they were able to keep those three people up until the other three people on their team were able to get back into the fight.
Yeah. That's truly amazing. Like, that is such a hard situation. It's essentially 6v3 there, and they just had to stay alive long enough. And they did it perfectly, actually. Lucio was sort of dodging behind the wall, staying out of the fire, while Zarya and Winston just took a big brunt of the force. And yeah, a lot of good teamwork, though. I mean, Mercy Shore looking a lot better here on Liu Shang around. Seems like they got the right compositions now. Seem to be gelling together as a team. April Wizards, not taking any credit away from them. They're doing pretty well for themselves. They're actually going to be running double hit scan here with free hit soldier.
They're going to be able to get a bit. Looks like a fight coming in on the point. We got six on Mercy Shore. They're going to try to snowball themselves in. But they're already getting picked off. Mirai's getting picked off.
Mirai's has to switch off that figure. Please switch off of that, Mirai's. Please, you're running up against double hit scan. It's gonna be so tough to try to get anything down here on the Pharah. Chromatic gonna pick up two. He's gonna pick up three on Zarya. Wowzer, he's going off right now. I mean, I know Chromatic. I do it all the time with him. This guy is insane on Zarya. He pretty much played a lot of her on in season two.
You know, that take was just so bad for Mercy Shore. I was just tongue-tied. I couldn't handle it.
Yeah, getting as the Pharah getting picked off so early, it's gonna be really tough to try to take that point, especially when you're technically the only DPS. They're still running the Mei, for Veiled Destiny. Graviton Surge is in the back. Oh, look, was looking for a boop there from Zedekus, but it's not gonna be it. Earthshatter. Oh, that's juicy. That's gonna be it right there.
And that was such a nice Mei wall from Veiled Destiny, just blocking out Chromatic and the McCree. Making sure they weren't able to do damage, but that Earth Shatter just tore him to shreds.
Thanks for the
assist. I definitely do agree with you. Marius definitely should be getting off of that Pharah, because he's not getting anywhere with that.
Yep. We're going to hit the 50% mark here for April Wizard. Yeah, and honestly, I think you have to keep Veiled Destiny on the Mei. His walls on this map, and especially the last one, have been fantastic. Always countering the Graviton Surge there. They just need to get Marius onto a Soldier or McCree, get that reliable hit screen damage in there. Think twice, he's gonna pick up Rakente at the very start of this fight. Sound Barrier comes through. I don't know how much it actually affected there. Think twice, damage boosted on the side. He's gonna pick up support for himself. Marius, he now has the Rocket Barrage. He's gonna pick up two kills, so it looks like but the res comes through. That's gonna be huge. Aimer Wizard's gonna have the man advantage coming into the latter half of this fight.
Doesn't look like Mercy Shore is gonna be able to stay on this point. I definitely think, unless by some miracle Harambe can knock them all off, but it doesn't look like it.
Nope.
Still a one-man army against six.
Oh, overtime comes in. Veiled Destiny, he gets knocked off. He couldn't self-ult. I don't even know what's called.
He couldn't make cancer ice block into the point to do stall tactics.
Yeah.
I know it's a mouthful. It's hard. This game's hard. You know what's even harder though? Casting this game. They should definitely be giving us platinum medals. You know, just not even giving any of them any of the medals. We just get platinum.
Platinum, wow. That's great. I would love one.
Yeah, solid platinum.
So, a little rough there for Mercy Shore. Complete dominance, though, for April Wizard there. They came out of the gate with double hit scan, and luckily it seemed like Marius played perfectly into their hand, and they did not have to switch off that double hit scan. But really, Chromatic actually was the true star of that point. I think he is getting so much burst or so much AOE damage off on this Zarya. He's getting a lot of high energy as well, consistent high energy kills. So I'm not sure what the answer is. You just keep doing the Mei wall when the Graviton Surge comes in, and hope your DPS can follow through here. Now Marius, he switched over to the Reaper for this last point here, deciding point here on Liu Zhang.
I think it'll definitely help him out for the better, but he's not able to really. Marius isn't able to really get in too hard. He's alone, and he's gonna get picked off by Chromatic.
Mm-hmm.
That flashbang is definitely going to be troublesome for him.
Yep.
But looks like Veiled Destiny able to play a little bit of stall tactics.
Yeah.
Maybe it'll help them get that extra time later on, but he's going to be apart from his team as they group up.
Yeah, I think that time difference will be equalized here by the split spawn. Let's see, let's look at the alt economy. Nothing yet, but April Wizards for sure are gonna have a better one going into this second fight here. Sound Barrier is gonna be up. Same with Attack Visor. Rez is getting pretty close as well. Rakente on Winston, he's going in. He's trying to pressure up Babur on the shoulder, and he has to go way back, deep flank around. Chromatic gonna pick up a double kill. And Think Twice coming in as well. And Attack Visor, he's a little too late. Maybe a waste there on the attack visor. He's gonna pick up Dano though. Not a complete waste.
And it looks like as we go into about the 50% mark, gonna be another push. They might need to do a hero swap just to try to maybe change up their game.
Oh, whoa. Did Zed boop someone? I didn't catch that.
I think so.
Oh, wow. Yeah, it's not looking good here. Rishada comes through. Deadeye is channeled as well on the side. Double kill for him through the Deadeye ult. And yeah, this is
a slaughter right now. Now, if you saw as I was going in, Dano got picked off by Chromatic as they were going in. They definitely weren't able to get any sort of speed on him. Like, I don't know if they had the speed boost trying to go in, but it definitely didn't.
Zed popping the sound barrier on his team that's on the point at the very least. Chromatic is going to pick up the first kill to fight onto Anna. And now the Graviton Surge comes through on both teams here. But the problem is, Mercy Shore is already dead.
If you look, AJS Zero on that Lucio tried to sound barrier, but he fell off.
Oh my god.
He fell off as he was trying to get that off.
Oh, I just saw it. Man, losing that point with four ultimates up, that's gonna haunt your dreams, man. Yeah.
You know
that fight was totally different than Sound Barrier game before.
Look at Marias coming in from behind. He's haunting your dreams this week.
Oh yeah, this is at the very end there. He's carrying Mercy Shore that first point there.
Oh, that headshot!
Yeah.
He just blocked that entire ult with one shot to the face. And, you know, even though they lost the war, you know, at least he won that little battle.
Mm-hmm.
Something to be proud of.
Yeah, I mean, and definitely looking a little bit better for Mercy Shore here.
Yeah.
Yep.
And that was 2-1 in favor of April Wizards.
So we're going to head into the last map of the night here, which will be Hanamura. 2-point capture. Assault is the official Overwatch term for these types of maps.
So is it like, what, assault, hybrid, payload?
Escort is what I think Overwatch calls it. Yeah, payload. I mean, that's a XTF2, but yeah, I always call it payload. And then control. King of the Hills are called control maps.
You know, they have to have like a little bit of a different naming convention so they can distinguish themselves.
Yeah.
I definitely think what's going to happen is Blizzard and Volvo are just going to merge into a giant super company.
My god.
It'll be like Voltron. Just get a bunch of the different game studios and just form a giant mega alliance.
Oh my god. There's no like regulatory body for video games. So like who would prevent that from happening? Like, what if Riot, Valve, and Blizzard all join forces? Like,
well, I don't think. All right, here's the thing: is that if Riot came in, they wouldn't be able to do much because it would just be like, "Hey guys, let's make one game."
Yeah, you're right. So only one MOBA, only one FPS.
Be like, "Hey guys, we're just gonna make this one game." It's like, "Oh, we gonna do anything else?" Nope.
I mean, think about if they made, like, the biggest MMO to date, like a super MMO. It defines the whole genre.
What if they made a League of Legends MMO?
You know, that's always been rumored. I don't know what... I feel like... do you know what Riot Games is making behind the scenes? A lot of people have a lot of different speculations. Some people think it's a fighting game. Some people think it's a trading card game. Or an MMO.
I mean, all right, if you think about them, what is the one thing that Riot loves most of all? Esports and money. So,
I like how money is one of the things they love.
They're going to try to find a way to make a game that's all about that's esports driven, and that will make them a shit ton of money.
Mm. That's true. And Blizzard now, well, yeah, with Overwatch coming out and Heroes of the Storm, they seem to be pretty esports heavy as well.
I don't know about too much. They're like really trying to push Heroes of the Storm, but I don't know.
They're
trying to go into League of Legends Dota territory, and that's already pretty well established. So, I mean,
yeah,
it's like trying to get competitive Splatoon. I don't know how it's going to happen.
Yeah. Anyway.
So, until it becomes a real thing, I'm gonna make fun of it.
Yeah. Alright, yes. Well, let's cast some Overwatch here. Let's see what they're doing.
Looks like they're gonna do a little bit of poking at the choke. Failed Destiny within Failed Destiny is gonna try to come in from behind.
Oh, that Maywall, very ineffective there coming out of the blue. It might have been a misclick, and Mercio, they're just going in. They're going hard, and they're already are touching this point early on in the fight. Marius, he's still alive on this McCree, trying to get the picks, trying to get the kills, and his team is so close to getting the first tick mark here. The Chromatic and Babur, they're coming back strong. Babur on the point, Esme trying to freeze up the remaining members of Mercy Shore, and it looks like it's going to be a pretty split fight for Mercy Shore here. Cruisemaster, he charges in, he's going to try to save his buddy there, but it won't be enough. Chromatic's going to pick up that kill, and Cruisemaster, you got to get out of there, bud. It's too dangerous to be a solo Reinhardt. Gradual Search comes out, where's that? Back at the front of the point. Only locks up Dano 22. Oh! Just kidding, sneaky Cruisemaster.
Cruisemaster, get out of the point, they don't know you're there.
You just made Laid think twice in the back. Do they not know?
I don't.
Do they care?
He's Secret Agent Cruz. Coming in for the... No!
Misses the Fire Strike. But he's gonna try to get the charge. Zarya Bubble comes through and saves Chromatic's life. Saves his own life. Brady Bastard. Flashbang comes through. Hook! He's gonna get locked up. CC Chain Chromatic. He's trying to stay alive. Grenade healing comes through from Anna on his team. Cruisemaster going in, trying to create the zone for his team to get in there. Nana boosted Deadeye is channeled. Will he find anyone? He's actually gonna get locked up in this blizzard! Will he go down before it? From the back, picks up the kill. Three quick kills for April Wizard. And Cruisemaster, he is doing so much work. Give this man a medal. But it's not going to be enough. Not even the first tick mark here. Damn. Hey, chill out.
You know, that was... I definitely think that Cruisemaster could have definitely split up the party if he would have just went to the point. If you think about it. Just try to just coordinate something to... kind of pincer them in, either have them work, make them worry about the point.
Ooh, Babur gets hooked in. Yeah, he'll run to safety. Shunodai gets slept here. Chromatic with the Graviton Surge. Self-Destruct gets popped by Failed Destiny, but not in the right spot. And Mercy Store, they're gonna get pushed back towards their spawn here. Think Twice with the... Ooh, the Tactical Visor. He gets hooked out and killed, and now the Earth Shatter comes through. Nano Boost onto Cruisemaster, and he's gonna get walled off from doing a maximum amount of damage here. And, man, Mercy Shore cleaning up that fight pretty well.
April Wizards aren't able to go against Mercy Shore.
Mercy Wizards. April Shore and Mercy Wizards.
Yep. And it looks like they're going to get the first point. Pushing in, seeing if they can have the momentum from this first point to go into the second one. This is definitely a crucial moment to see if they can try to force something.
Yeah, man, but it looks like April Wizards, their spawn timing was pretty good there, and they were smart about it. Not overcommitting for that first point, and they are set and ready for this push in here. Blue is going to get a very early pick. Dano 22, though, he answers back onto Chromatic on the Zarya. That's a pretty big kill to get. Rodog hook misses. Zed going to pick up another kill.
But they're not really capitalizing on that Chromatic pick.
Nah. Yeah, they can't now. Rakente going down there on that Rodog, but... they need to set up some kind of defense here, but will they find out Babur here? He's on this side here. Think Twice able to take up Marius in the close 1v1 duel there. Cruisemaster by himself on this ride. I feel like he doesn't even care about his shield anymore. He's just going in full melee Reinhardt at this point. It's been working for him.
He's just like Genji, just with a bigger weapon that's a hammer.
He doesn't have the mad hops either. He's wearing a lot of armor.
You don't need the mad hops when you got, you know, that big of a hammer.
Yeah.
He is faster though, if you think about it. He can dash quite a ways.
Yeah, and April Wizards here, they're looking for... looking to basically just cut him off here at this upper choke. Think twice, pops the attack visor, sound barrier comes through before the Graviton Surge, attack visor can do all of the damage. Rise channels Deadeye. Will he get a kill? He does, he picks up Think twice there. I'd say that's worth... Here we go, four members for April Wizards up on this top half here. Ana Grenade comes through, stalls him, stalls the healing. Babur now trying to force something here. Chromatic going hard. Babur's gonna pick up the kill into Rakente, and they're gonna get pushed back. Mercy Shore just going down before the rest of the two remaining members can help reinforce the fight.
I think the biggest thing I'm seeing is that they're too scared to really jump onto the point as a team. They just stayed in that upper right area, just leading themselves to be just firing targets.
Yeah. Yeah, I think they were just waiting for their two members there, but... Oh yeah, you're right. It's really actually April Wizards who took the initiative there, and they realized, hey, there's only four of them up there. Let's go for them, split their spawns even more. Picked up a couple of kills, and... Yeah, now it's just a big waiting game for Mercy Shore before they can regroup. Look at the ult economy, though, for April Wizards. Holy crap. Five ults. I don't see Mercy Shore winning this fight at all. Blizzard comes through right onto that bridge area. Channeled into a Graviton Surge. This is... Not even close, baby. Oh my god.
I don't even know. I'm speechless. I'm speechless right now. Cruise Master swinging away at his hammer, but he can't even do anything.
Yeah. Hopefully, Mercy Shore doesn't get too down on themselves for that fight. There's really nothing they could have done. Those alts are always going to win that fight every time. But unfortunately, like I said earlier in this match, April Wizards, they're so good at managing their ult economy. They never overcommit. They only used two, maybe three ults that fight. And they still have three big ones. They have Attack Visor, Res, and Earth Shatter. Hook comes in on the Think twice, but that is exactly what Mercy Shore needed. And now this is the go button. They just have to go. AGS Hero pops the speed, and they have to go strong here. Self Destruct comes through. Build Destiny. I don't know where that one's really trying to go. Not going to be able to pick up anybody. And Mirai's on the top half. Nano Boost at Deadeye. He's going to pick up two kills from it. And this is a very good fight for Mercy Shore right now. Earthshatter comes through right before Cruise Master goes down. And Chromatic, he's kind of the last hope on this point. He's going to just try to stay alive. Bubble comes through. Off cooldown, will it be enough? He goes down, the point is being capped, but Rez comes through! It's gonna pick up two members for April Wizards. Earthshatter now, oh no, see now these are the ultimates they had! They're coming in at the very end of this fight, now that Rez is so huge, might have just won them this fight.
And it looks like they're still trying to get, you know, lick their wounds and trying to regroup back there. Having 2 minutes left to try to get maybe two or three more pushes, but you know, even though it was great that Marius was able to pick off the Mercy, but Chromatic on the Zarya was just able to stall out just enough to allow Tacos Kaboom just get an easy res off to continue the fight.
Yeah. Wowzers, yeah, it's looking tough now for Mercy Shore. They only have a minute 20 left. Just got Sound Barrier. That's good. That's a good ult to start a fight here.
Definitely trying to come in, trying to eke their way inside, but Chromatic, being the ballsiest person in the league, going, hey, you can't do... Oh, what is Shooter Die doing?
She's doing the head bump into wall taunt.
Definitely.
Okay, so... 3-3 for alts here.
Yeah, 3-3, but they have the Zarya and they have the Mail. And they're gonna combo that.
Yep, Deadeye comes through on the ledge now. Graviton Surge onto Mercy Shore team. Shooter Die gonna follow up with the Earth Shatter, charging on Rakente's Roadhog. Will he stay alive? Blizzard comes through, but not really locking up anyone though. Chromatic gonna pick up a double kill. Self Destruct comes through, totally blocked off by Reinhardt there, and now Think twice. With a nano boost on the soldier. Flashbang, but Rai's gonna go down in the corner. And yeah, that's gonna be it here. Mercy Shore only getting one point here.
If not, that's April Wizards game. So the finals, or the score for them would be what, 3-7? 4-6. 4-6. That was definitely what it was supposed to be.
Think twice with the play of the game here on Soldier. Let's see what this one's all about here on first point. Oh yeah, he's going off. Really good tracking there. That's all, yeah, right? He even had tech visor at the end of that. 32% of the team's damage. Doing a lot of good work on 76 there.
Epic. Someone needs to show how it's done.
Definitely, all those Blizzards were definitely on point. I mean, every time you saw a Blizzard, you saw plays being made. I don't think I could see a Blizzard that was made. A May Blizzard that was not play. As you know, as the saying goes, April Wizards bring May Blizzards.
Mm-hmm. That is what they. That is what they say. Yeah.
Yep. Now let's see if Mercy Shore can do. Maybe they'll do even better with their defense if they can hold up that first. At first point, they'll definitely be on, at least they'll be feeling a little bit better. Even though they did not come out ahead on capture points, they can still try to get more points out of this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and every bit counts here going into the second half of the regular season. It's about getting this valuable time together as a team, playing in an official match. Stakes are, you know, higher than just playing quick play or some random scrim, and finding out what enemy teams like to do on certain maps is pretty big too going into the playoffs.
If you think about it, this is how Overwatch is meant to be played, as a team, as, you know, against other teams, making sure to see, guess what, who's the better team.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's totally different than solo queue. It's everything is so much more coordinated, so much more crisp. Picks are punished harder. Compositions can vary, actually. Solo queue, usually everyone likes to stick to the standard 2-2-2 and never fluctuate. But yeah, we've seen so far in this season, at least for the Patty Overwatch League, teams run many different team compositions. And Taco's going boom. He's going hard in the paint here on this Winston. He's going to get frozen up. He's going to pick up that first blood of the fight here on Hanamura. Gonna pick up another kill for himself as well, but Chromatic, he's coming in, trying to even the fight here. Bluer, he's on the Soldier 76. He's gonna try to loop around here, go left, and get behind him, maybe take out some of the supports for Mercy Shore, and he does. Yeah, Daniel 22, he's in a bad spot. He's hit Hoffman. Will he stay alive for a little bit longer? He will, but will eventually go down, and yeah, this looks like a real quick cap here for April Wizards.
If Mercy Shore isn't careful enough, they could use the momentum that they got from this point just to try to go into the next one.
Mm-hmm.
But if you look at the ult economy that they have, there's 70% on Soldier, they have the Earth Shatter on Shooter Die, and 60% on the Graviton Surge. All they have to do is just build up their ults a little bit, and they'll be gold.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that point capture happened so quickly. We only really have one ult so far ready in this game. It's a lot of these heroes haven't realized their full potential yet.
And if you look at it, Shooter Die has already jumped in. They're already in the fight. Earthshatter going down, making sure Rakente gets down. And that sound barrier, making sure everyone's gonna stay healthy. Counter sound barrier on the defensive team. Oh, but Chromatic getting double tank. And it looks like they're killing each other, it looks like April Wizard is getting a clean sweep.
They're gonna win this with 8 minutes and 5 seconds left. That,
if that's not slapping someone with your dick, I don't know what is.
I don't think I've actually seen that fast of a Hanamura before. Shoot or die. I mean, there was only one. This is like the first ult of the whole map here, or the whole offense for April Wizards.
Nope.
Oh no, actually no, there's a couple before that. But he had it ready the first and just swinging away. I don't know about that Overwatch. I don't know if that was the point of the game. But he did fantastic. Shiro Dai, honestly, I think plays the best Reinhardt.
Oh yeah. It's always, you never know what he's gonna do. He's always getting, but the one thing you can be certain he's gonna do is getting those guaranteed ults off, getting at least three people, and making sure that you're gonna just get a clean sweep afterwards.
Yeah, no, totally. He does a really good job of trying to bait out the enemy Reinhardts and absorbs it with his shield, and then he just answers with a Earth Shatter of his own. Also, really good on the charges too. He's not always the first to go in, but he stays alive and then just countercharges back.
I think definitely you saw the difference in attacking size for Hanamura, because April Wizards, after that first point, like once they saw a slight opening, they rushed right in to get to the point. Now, if you looked at what Mercy Shore did, they kind of just pussyfooted every chance they got to just jump on the point.
Yeah.
And I don't know about you, but sometimes playing a little bit more aggressively, even though you might, you know, get out, you can still, or you get killed, you're still going to bait out a few ults. You're going to maybe get yourself an advantage in another way later on. But if you don't, but if you just stay where you are and just poke at the choke, nothing's going to happen.
Yep. Especially nowadays. Yep. Couldn't agree more.
Especially now that, you know, it's a lot of it has to do with the, it's not too much of an ult meta anymore because of the nerfs to ults and ult charge time. Can't really play that way anymore.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so that's our cue. So it was great week four. As always, I'm UTech.
I'm 30.
And bye.